Wow.
Oh, fucking hell.
That's a tricky question.
I don't know.
When I first get to the Unicorn in Spain, and I see a lot of riders that I didn't even believe that there is so many people that know how to ride on a unicycle.
In my first EC winter, I think it was after the Flatland finals, we all stayed up like till like 4 a.m. riding in the skate park. It was really good because I remember like, I didn't know very many people there. Mm-hmm. And I just started riding with them all, and it just, I know now they're all really good friends.
Ich glaube, die Summer EUC 2015, die war ziemlich cool, insgesamt. Naja, einfach die Stimmung, die da ist und wie alle sich gegenseitig anfeuern, wenn irgendwer was versucht. Und es ist einfach so, wenn man mit den Leuten zusammen ist, vergisst man den Rest der Welt.
Probably meeting the Pohams. They're like my heroes, and they're like riding with me. Especially Elias.
Après les championnats du monde de Tokyo, bah déjà les championnats en eux-mêmes étaient incroyables, c'était mes meilleurs. Et puis après ça, on allait à Hirosaki, donc c'est là où il y a le club Toyota qui ont gagné les groupes freestyle encore une fois cette année, ils en ont gagné pas mal. Et puis on logeait chacun chez un monocycliste dans leur famille, puis on s'entraînait avec le club Kimura Sensei, Miko Kimura, c'est celle qui a 72 ans là, qui travaille là, et celle qui a créé le style monocycle dance. Elle n'a jamais roulé en monocycle, mais elle a créé toutes les chorégraphies de monocyclistes, etc. Et partager ces 3 semaines avec eux, c'était dingue.
Like when I started unicycling, I had so much motivation to watch videos, and I was like fucking excited for everything. And like, I don't know, it was my best, I think.
I think it would have to be some of the final battles at Winter at UC. Because they are lit and the crowd is so energized and everyone's throwing tricks that are just massive. It's a good time.
Driving the Voodoo Bang bus to Italy and meeting a load of people who at that time I didn't really know. But by the end of like a week and a half, they were like my best friends. I think that's one of my best memories of the unicycle.
I think it's when I finally got to ride for the first time, because I'd been able to do it for a while, but I was afraid to let go of the fence that I was practicing with, and then I could finally go a whole round at once. Yeah, I think that's it.
Le flat à Saint-Sébastien, aux derniers Unicorn. Franchement, c'était mes premiers Unicorn et voir tous les meilleurs riders du monde. Enfin, voilà. Vraiment, enfin, le flat aux Unicorn.
Flatrando. Extase.
After Montreal, after Unicorn, a trip through the Rocky Mountains with unicycles riding. Crystal was riding downhill, I was riding every skate park I could find. It was pretty sweet.
I think Convention Fizer was the goodbye party of Unicorn in Montreal, where people just danced for hours together.
Le road trip avec les Merca pour aller à l'Unicorn à Montréal. C'était un chouette moment et d'aller rencontrer tous les riders et d'être accueilli par des gens qu'on connaissait même pas mais qui faisaient du mono, alors ils avaient le même esprit que nous. C'était vraiment cool.
Well, it's hard to think of one single memory because I have a lot of things to remember. If I really have to think of just one thing, then probably I would say the time when they arrived to Kisflock 2007. That was my very first international unicycle convention. I just arrived there with Chris Kovac and Benny Vintage. And you know, like all the scene was there, like everyone. That I remember that was a huge gym and we just walked over there and that was the window and we just looked down and I was like, oh my God, there's Joe Hodges, Kevin McMullen and like all the other riders. And we were so hyped for that event. We were riding from like 8 in the morning until like 11 in the evening. And like, what the reason why I like to remember that is that I try to keep that motivation and I try to bring back that motivation even on the harder days when I seek motivation for riding. And I really like to remember that. So probably I would pick that.
glaube, die ganzen Nächte nach dem Einradfahren sind am schönsten, wenn alle zusammen sind, wie heute. Everybody's friendly to each other, and that's really nice. Yeah, I like it. Like, it's not only competition, everybody's nice to each other. I like that very much.
C'est une fois, on était en France à une compétition, ça s'appelle Dijon sur la roue. Et on se baladait en ville un soir, on buvait des bières et tout ça. Et on a croisé un gars qui a demandé s'il pouvait essayer notre monocycle. Et on a dit ouais, vas-y, essaye. Il a essayé, il a posé des crank flips et tout ça. Et en fait, ce gars, c'était Thomas Petraco qui était dans la team Coxswain. Et c'est la première fois de ma vie que je voyais. Et c'était incroyable, c'était vraiment mon fan de l'époque. Et j'étais tellement content de le voir, c'était incroyable, vraiment.
Ok, well, it's definitely having a really good time with Emil Mathieu and Christian Brink and Simon Berry, Laura Benz and everyone else who chilled at Emil's after Unicorn Montreal, because we spent 2 weeks doing some of our favorite things, including unicycling.
General best memory, probably a summer 2013 road trip with Mike, Gareth, the boys around Europe, ending in Toulouse for EC summer. Just general, like, as a one thing that kind of summarizes the entire unicycle vibe and community, it was that summer. But that's also kind of every summer, but that one in particular was the best.